Welcome to the Stateless Code video. This is episode number 9 in our series, Enough Inkscape to be Dangerous. And so, in our previous video, we got the transparent version of this Why Stateless Code logo done. And so, I'm going to turn this into a... a logo with a background, and then do a 2-to-1 ratio and a wallpaper with it. So we'll get going on that. The first thing I'm going to do is save as here. Let's call this ystatelesscode.svg. That's fine. We'll replace it. And let's go to layers. So the only thing I'm going to really do here, I'm going to keep all these layers in place, and I'm just going to add a layer below here. Call it background. And this will be, everything else is locked. This is just going to be our rectangle fill here. Actually, I wonder if I can just copy and paste it from Stateless Square logo. All right, so we've got the very least I can for some reason it's not giving me any layer information at all here. Oh, that's probably because I'm not opening the Inkscape version of this. And Inkscape has crashed on me. All right, we are uncrashed. Square Inkscape version, so we can at least cheat off of the gradient here. So we need to re-add our base layer here. block everything else. And we're a bit small here, but I think I can just do lock it. All right. So the question is, do I need to change my colors here? I might need to go a little maybe lighter or darker. Give it a shot both ways. First, we'll see what happens if we go lighter here. So 65, 45, 84, 88. If we do 75, 65. That becomes much harder to read, so we'll undo that. We'll go darker on this one. So that was 75, 45. Maybe 60. Ooh, yes. Much easier to read. Still easy to read, a little bit more gradient. I think save that. And I think we're good to go there. So let's do the 2-to-1 ratio now. This would be 300. Only problem there is that that moves everything that should, fine, we need to save this as, this shouldn't be a problem. I'm just going to go through we'll start with the base. Rectangle itself. I'll unlock this. Let's make this 300. And then I just need to center all this stuff vertically, except for the arrow. Is locked. Text. I'm just going to change the x-axis on it. Gives me what I want there. And now I need to try to figure out how to do this with a wallpaper. So close this document. I will probably see Inkscape crash again. All right, so I've uncrashed now. Let me see. So I've got the exit wallpaper open. We will save as Why stateless code wallpaper? And then we'll lock layer one for now. Create a layer above it. Actually, we'll move the layer, the logo layer down a level. Now I'm going to try to import So this gives me kind of the full, okay, so I want locked. So I think I'm going to keep the larger logo and have a version that's just the golden circle. And then kind of import that as a layer like that. So let me go back to the transparent. Delete you out. Now we're probably going to crash again. All right, we managed to close without saving. Let me fire things back up. All right, so we're back here to this version. I'm going to do golden circle only here. For this, I'm just going to go into the logo layer and delete it. Save. Now I'll go back into the we'll close this one. Open the wallpaper. I may have saved it somewhere weird. to wallpaper rotate. Let me find, pause and find the file. So whatever happened to that, I have lost it. So we'll just go back and do our... Okay, that's the crash backup there. So we'll do our doesn't really matter, I don't think. We'll do code along as our basis anyway. So now add a layer. Above the base. Lock the other layers for now. Import golden circle. Make it larger. Okay, and then I'm going to align and distribute this. Actually, I'll bottom align this. Oh, that is not what I wanted. There we go. Go back to our layer one here. So we're going to get rid of code along, get rid of this. Let's go to our logo now. I think that works. Yeah, I like that. So save that. And we've got the SVGs for those. I'll go in and export them as PNG files in GIMP. We've done that in our previous videos, and we'll stop there. So a quick addendum to what I was doing before. The as I was exporting these in GIMP, I realized that I had saved and overwritten my code along wallpaper here. Why is this in such unhelpful order? Just do a new document, open the one I need. So open the incorrect code along wallpaper here. Save as. Save it as Stateless Code wallpaper, and then I've got a backup copy of my code along wallpaper that I'll restore from my other machine. So just tie up that loose end.
Want to create your own Ruby gem but don't know where to start? Code along with me on the end-to-end journey of the Nerd Dice project. We'll configure and publish the gem, use GitHub Actions to trigger builds and tests, and create magic methods with Ruby metaprogramming that can roll any number of dice, all while using a test-driven approach. Go to statelesscode.com/nerddicegem to level up.
Thanks for watching this Stateless Code video. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. Check out our growing library of videos on our social media channels, follow us at Stateless Code, and taxation is theft.